Hello, I have with me Amit Gupta. He's the co-founder CEO for Yulu Bikes. Welcome, Amit.
Thank you, Shweta. Pleasure to be here.
Same here. Amit, firstly about you're the co-founder. So how you thought about Yulu and the thought behind founding it, and it has been in the market for some time now. We have seen your Yulu Bikes around. So something about.
Sure. So before Yulu, I was running InMobi. I'm also co-founder of InMobi. Had great time building that company, and we took it to profitability, became unicorn, and did a lot of interesting things about that. And when InMobi was started, there was no mobile advertising, there was no mobile internet either. But a bunch of us had a belief that in 10 years, this will be absolutely changing. And I think we were correct on that. InMobi started when I was 30 years age. And when I was 20, I thought that I will be an entrepreneur by 30. So that's the context. And somewhere when I was like 32, 33, and I had my own life goal that by 40, I should be retiring, okay. Done with corporate life and maybe enjoy some beach home. When I was about to turn 40, realized that that's not what I want to do. And some deeper introspection, talking to mentors, made me realize that the joy of giving to society is what probably will make me happy. And that's what actually led me to figure out what can I do for the society. And the how part was the entrepreneurship. That's what I learned last many years, right? And looked at several problems. India has unfortunately a lot of them. Finding a problem was not a big deal. But a problem which is closer to me where I can relate for next 10 years. And I thought that this whole traffic congestion where people are spending 3-4 hours on the road, and this is going from their own personal life. It's going from the family time, from your hobby time, and if not physically sick, it's making you mentally sick. Your mental well-being is actually tremendous pressure. Another linked problem which is coming to our big cities is the air pollution, which is actually making us sick on a regular basis. Interestingly, 40% of the air pollution happens because of vehicle. So if we solve something where the traffic congestion can get better, and we can do something about the air quality, that's like a double bonus for us. And that's where the thought of Yulu came into picture, where we thought that people moving in their own car, big vehicle, alone, they are just taking too much of resources. At the same time, they're guzzling lot of carbon emission. And on one hand, we wanted to make vehicles smaller, because we cannot just magically reduce the number of vehicles. What we can do, we can make them smaller. And secondly, rather than they running on fossil fuel, can we run them on eco-friendly way? So that's how Yulu Vehicles got formed. So our first product was bicycle product. This is absolutely zero pollution, as we all of us know. And the second product, because people needed to go long distance, we basically got an EV to help us with that use case. So EV is also helping on the pollution and also helping with the efficient mobility of people in the cities.
So this EV bike is your innovation for the day-to-day?
Yes.
Yulu Miracle?
Correct. Okay. Even our first bike was also designed by us. It is created for shared mobility. So it's not that we just took a normal cycle, put it up. So there was a lot of innovation around that also. But EV, we had to do much more than what we had to do with bicycle. Reason being that making an EV is much more complicated process than making a cycle.
Okay, yeah.
Second, with EV, you also have to figure out how do you charge that. And we started in the regime where there was no standard battery specification, there was no charging infrastructure, there was no vehicle manufacturers who were willing to make it for us. So we had to do that, all of it. And then nudging the policy front where we basically needed to do something from the cities so that we can grow the business. So it was multiple dimension where we have to deal with.
That brings me to the second or a third question, that what are the challenges you faced apart from the physical challenges you just mentioned about the battery and the other stuff? What are the other challenges you faced during the process?
So you're right, there are not one, but there were 10, maybe 10,000 problems. The toughest problem for us has been changing the mindset, where people who are so used to be in their own comfort of the car, they used to be moving A to B the way they have been from the last 10 years. and you are suddenly telling that, hey, you let go of this car and move on Yulu, people don't take that very easily, as you know. At the same time, what has helped us, because today the pain of finding, let's say, an Uber or Ola during office time is insanely crazy. You are very lucky, by the way, you live in Bombay, where getting into an auto rickshaw and not haggling is not what you have to do. But try to take an auto rickshaw in Bangalore or Chennai or in Delhi, you will know the pain. So from our perspective, our first set of users were the folks who had to go with this haggling or had to wait infinitely for on-demand taxi. So rather than they waiting for those vehicles to come, they said, I can take Yulu and in 15 minutes flat, I will cut down on the traffic and I'll get to my destination very, very quickly. And we were also very clear that we're not trying to solve all of the use cases. We were solving only for 0 to 5 kilometer distance use cases, where for you to make this behavior change was not very difficult. So this is how we got started. But going forward, more and more people coming, they're saying, okay, I'll do some compromise, I'll use Yulu rather than, and I'll use maybe public transportation. You know, we want our big cities to have metro, buses, the public transportation, as we say, or from private players. We're a big supporter of their pool product. So we are a big supporter, for example, an Uber pool product, where someone can from their home can come to a common point using Yulu or for walking, that's not a problem. And then Uber or one of the shared pool company vehicle is coming, they get into that and get to their destination. That's how we can reduce number of vehicles, personal vehicles on the road. So that's our vision of the future.
Do you see any competition for Yulu?
So if I look at it, I think the need of urban mobility is only increasing. Look at the population of Bangalore, Mumbai, Delhi. It's only going up every year. Millions of people are coming to the city, which means there's an ongoing increasing demand of urban mobility. And our existing infrastructure for moving these people is not adequate. What government can do, they can keep on adding metro, which is happening as we speak in all big cities. Also, bus systems, again, you see some of the initiatives given taken by the government. I think that's the right thing to do. Now, we have a space where we have to solve for the short distance or what we call first mile or last mile. And if you look at, let's say, New Delhi, there are good companies that are trying to do something on, let's say, an e-rickshaw. There are companies where there's a bike taxi, where someone will ferry you, take you from A to B. What Yulu is doing, you're saying that, hey, most of us know how to ride a two-wheeler. We can provide you something at very convenient spots and you can pick vehicle from one spot and move it to metro or to your office areas. I think because of mobility, urban mobility, especially for the first and last mile, is so broken and it's so big, there will be many players, different form factors. And from a competition perspective, I think all of us are evolving. So the space is very new, almost 2 to 3 years old only. And there are some competition right now. I'm sure that as we progress the business, there will be more companies emerging in this space.
So you said that Yulu has been 3 to 4 years.
We are only 2 year old company.
2 years
old. Our category is only 3 years old.
Okay.
It is such a new category.
So Amit, do you think that since 2 years, the way you had visioned Yulu to grow, it has grown that much, or was it so accommodating from the public, the idea?
So if I truly tell you, when I made the first business plan, had 100,000 vehicles on the street in 18 months.
Oh.
Now, if I tell you the current number, it is 1/10.
That's amazing.
Right? 1/10. So I was anyway extrapolating, or I was overly optimistic that I'll come, I'll just change the word and everything will happen. What is fascinating though, you know, I can look at this picture that, oh my God, I was like, I hit my target to only 10% level. But I was stepped back. And looked back, hey, you know, what problem set I was dealing with. It was not just about designing a scooter. The set of things which we had to do in this process, the innovation we speak about, we did not anticipate that when I started this journey. And if I can say I'm wiser today because I'm dealing with a real Indian problem, I think what we have achieved is probably very, very good. Even if I am, like, as a company, we are well below the target which we set it up 2.5 years ago. But I think what we have achieved in absolute sense is amazing. Now we think, and I think this conviction is real, backed by solid execution and resources, by March 2021, we will have 100,000 EVs. And that plan is committed, sealed, and we think we'll deliver on that.
Sure. We think the same. It was quite a welcoming thought, though, by the audience, or rather by the consumers, I can say.
True, true. And we're also pleasantly surprised when we talk to users. And you can also, by the way, do a Twitter search on our handle. You will see a lot of things about Yulu. 8 out of 10 people will say positive things, or at least, and those 2 people will say constructive thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we hardly see issues where people are literally just yelling at us. They will say, I'm very sad, but I'm really, you know, in love with Yulu. Can you fix this problem? Can you fix that problem? And we are happy with that. I think any feedback, constructive feedback, which is making us better, is always welcome. And we are overwhelmed with the response we have got, the support we have got. In fact, one thing which I presented to the jury, in our cities, we did not have any spaces for parking. And I also say that people kill each other for even single inch of space, right?
Okay.
In our case, we were given spaces to create those preferred parking areas. We call them Yulu zones, by big corporates, residential complexes. Even cities came and they said, okay, you take this space next to the metro station, this shopping mall, this high street, this bus station. All of them are not charging us any money. Imagine. Why they are doing it? Because they believe that what Yulu is doing is actually helping the city, helping them particularly. So this whole feeling of collaborativeness, I hoped, I wished, but it is just way too good to be true. So we are very, very privileged to be in this country where everyone's like, okay, red carpet, welcome. What do you need from me? I'll make it happen. So we are very happy about that.
Amit, how was it coming to Aegis Graham Bell Awards and presenting Yulu Miracle in front of the jury?
I'm very, very honored. First of all, not many people understood in the beginning that we're talking about innovation. In India, people say, you know, jugaad, but sometimes they misuse that. But in our context, we actually have done several innovations. As a founding team, we always had this notion that we should have a problem-first approach. And from our perspective, there's a problem. If there's a solution which we can take from other markets, from other contexts, apply it, we have no ego. So we are not a team who will do innovation for the heck of it. At the same time, because EV ecosystem is so new, micro-mobility, this whole domain, as I said, only 3 years old, there are several missing pieces. So from creation of the parking, to charging, to vehicle, to several processes, how do you safeguard your vehicles from vandalism and theft? Each one of it, we have to innovate. I think your platform is actually truly, truly about innovation. And we getting nominated, at least to start with, to present in front of you guys in the jury itself, was a big honor, which means that we are among set of thousands of companies, maybe hundreds of us, who got this opportunity to be at least tagged as, you know, this company is doing some innovation. Whether we make it to the final round or not, we don't know, because good part is not just Yulu, but there's several other entrepreneurs who are actually innovating. Big fan of them. So for us, it's a nomination itself is a big privilege. And if we get to the final round and maybe getting an innovator award, it means a lot.
We wish you the same and good luck.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us here.